Hey guys, Sid here, and today I'm gonna review the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. So, let's get started. So, as all of you know, the latest flagship from Samsung is Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. And today we have it here. For first of all, I would like to give a huge shout out to my buddy Shibu for generously giving me the S10 Plus for review purposes. I'm pretty sure this video wouldn't be possible if he wasn't there. So let's get to the awesome part, the review. First of all, let's talk about the hole on the screen. Well, as the race to have the largest screen to body ratio tightens, Samsung has decided to skip the notch and instead introduce punch hole display. Yep, your brand new S10 Plus comes with a hole in the display from the factory. This is cool because Samsung totally skipped the notch by making the S9 Plus with a bezel last year and the S10 Plus with a hole this year. Though some might call this hole a glorified notch, in my opinion, the way of placing the camera in a hole is less intrusive and easier to forget that it exists than a notch, which gets a bit of getting used to, while the hole is instant to not get noticed. Also, it helps that the hole is way on the side while the notch is right in the middle. And Samsung is calling this new display the Infinity O display. Since we started with the display, let's move down to the bottom of the display. The bottom of the display hides yet another high-tech feature of the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. Yep, the on-screen ultrasonic fingerprint sensor. Unlike other in-glass fingerprint sensors seen on some of the devices like the OnePlus 6T and the Samsung Galaxy A50 that I showcased on the previous video, this one which are based on optical image fingerprints, while this one is based on ultrasonic image of the fingerprint, which allows it to work without emitting light, thereby not causing screen bleeding, which is common for optical in-glass fingerprint sensors, as each time you unlock, they have to emit bright light to get the image properly. Also, ultrasonic sensors are smaller than the optical sensors, thereby allowing for the 3.5mm headphone jack to stay. Though it is worth noting that they are not as fast as capacitive fingerprint sensors on the S10e and other smartphones like the OnePlus 6. It is faster than the optical ones, sure, but not as fast as the capacitive ones. Samsung has removed the iris scanner this time around and replaced it with the face unlock, which to be honest is not very secure because there have been a lot of videos out there on the internet that shows it being tricked by a video of a person, like a YouTube video. It was shown in the Unbox Therapy, where he showed his Samsung Galaxy device, S10 device, a video of him presenting another tech video. It got unlocked, so I don't think that's very secure. Anyways, the screen is 6.4-inch Quad HD Plus Dynamic AMOLED Infinity O display, that is Gorilla Glass. Yep, a long name for a display. And as usual, display is just dope. Obviously, as Samsung produces displays for most of the flagship, they will be top notch. Okay, now talking about build quality, it is great, it is strong and very light. Even with all that hardware, flagship quality hardware in it, the S10 Plus comes in two materials, either glass or ceramic back. The one I have here is the glass back in prism blue color. They are also available in prism white, prism black, and in ceramic black and ceramic white in ceramic back. Now, talking about the specifications, the S10 Plus has few options. All the S10 Plus variants, and for that matter, even the S10 variants and even the S10e variants come with the same processor, the latest Qualcomm Snapdragon 855. Though in India, Samsung uses the Exynos processor, and thus we have the Samsung Exynos 9820. It is worth noting that Exynos 9820 is slightly lower performing than the Snapdragon 855, though they provide a great performance as compared to other flagships out there. There is no lag in graphics intensive games like PUBG Mobile and Asphalt 9. Heating only occurs on gaming for a long time. Even with 8GB RAM, and in spite of having over 50 apps installed, there wasn't any performance decrease. Now, Talking about audio, it has great audio, though it only has one speaker at the bottom, and the connectivity is as solid as it can be. We were able to get brilliant reception of both Volt and Wi-Fi signals, as you can see from screenshots here. The memory options available for the S10 Plus are 8 gigs of RAM, 128 gigabit storage, 8 gigs of RAM and 512 gigabytes of storage, and a whopping 12 gigabytes of RAM and 1 terabyte of storage. And on top of that, all the variants have a hybrid memory expansion slot for up to 512 gigabytes extra via SD card. That makes it a total of 1.5 TB of storage on the highest version. That is just insane. Though, all this comes at a price. The S10 Plus starts at 73,900 rupees for the 128GB version and 91,900 for the 512GB version, and a whopping 1,17,900 rupees for the 1TB version. That's a lot of money. Now, coming to the camera options available on the S10 Plus, it is great. There's a total of 5 cameras. Yep. 3 on the back and 2 on the front. The 3 cameras on the back are 12MP telephoto sensor with f2.4 aperture and OIS, a 12MP wide angle sensor with dual aperture at f1.5 and f2.4 and OIS, which is normal default sensor, and a 16MP ultra wide sensor with f2.2 aperture and no OIS. While the front has a setup of 10MP selfie camera and an f1.9 aperture and no OIS, and an 8MP RGB depth sensor with f2.2 aperture and no OIS. All the cameras of the S10 Plus are pretty good. They produce well detailed images, as you can see from the examples here. They have very good performance in the outdoors, but they tend to underperform indoors, just like many of the Samsung devices. Also, as usual with Samsung devices, the images are slightly overexposed. Though this could be useful for photographers, as it will capture more detail, and thus once the exposure is reduced in post, it will have better detail. The ultra-wide sensor allows for some unique perspectives and also great for architecture photography. Though at times, for people they might seem a bit weird. It also has the usual AR emojis and other filters, though it does not have a dedicated night mode like the ones found on other devices, but instead the night mode on this is based on the scene recognition feature that the camera uses to identify and process the images taken on the basis of the scenes it was taken in, and this night mode is not as great as the night sight found on the Pixel 3. Another some features that are included is the native support for an Instagram option. If you take a pic using that, you can directly post it to an Instagram story instead of going into Instagram. The video and the audio quality are pretty decent as well. As you can see from this 1080p 30fps video, it can also shoot up to 4K 60fps with HDR 10 Plus, and the HDR 10 Plus on this device is awesome. Also in slow motion, we have 240fps at 1080p, 480fps at 960 and 960fps at 720p. Though they can only be of very short durations, like 0.8 and 0.4 seconds respectively. It also has hyperlaser 1080p, and it can also capture 9.1 megapixels of images during 4K video recording. The video is very smooth, as you can see from the footage here, especially with the super steady video option enabled. Now, talking about battery life, though the S10 Plus has a 4100 mAh battery, due to the power hungry processor and the big display, the battery life kind of sucks. The battery drops from 100% to 80% just about a few hours of even idle, and with moderate use it drops up to 50%. Though this has been solved to an extent in the March security update received on the April 1st. Now it can handle up to 2 games and a full day of use, but the fact it charges up very fast helps, as it only takes 1 hour 12 minutes to charge from 0 to 100%. They also have another very handy feature that allows sharing the battery power via power share. The power share option, that is essentially reverse wireless charging though it is worth noting that it only has 9 watts, which is very slow, but hey, it is plenty to charge small accessories like Galaxy Buds, though they can also charge other Qi wireless charging devices. Though it is worth noting that the reverse charging will cost about 10% more than what you give. That is, if you charge another device 20%, we lose 30%. And since it has wireless reverse charging, it also has proper wireless charging, which is also pretty fast to charge up the device. Another downside of the S10 Plus is that the power button is quite high, making it difficult to reach almost always. Now, when it comes to the OS, S10e, S10 and S10 Plus run on Android Pie with Samsung's new skin, the One UI, that has a material design which has a built-in dark theme. Another cool feature is that the Bixby button, yep, it still exists on the device, but is now remappable. Though it can't be remapped to other voice assistants, it can be remapped to other apps and functions. But there is a catch, because you can only remap one function of the button. So either the single press or the double press should still be to open the Bixby. Now, to sum up, the S10 Plus is the best smartphone you can buy right now, excluding the few downsides I mentioned. Though it might not have the greatest value to the cost ratio, especially with the Huawei P30 Pro out in the market right now. But it at least has a great screen to body ratio. The S10 and the S10e are also great options as the internals are pretty safe. The main difference between the S10 Plus and the S10 are the S10's has only 6.1 inch Quad HD Plus display instead of the 6.4 inch on the S10 Plus, and the lack of the depth camera in the front and the 3400 mAh battery. While the S10e is missing some more features, as it has a 5.8 inch Full HD Plus display, single 1080p front camera and dual camera setup on the back, with the wide that is the normal lens and the ultra wide. The telephoto is missing on the S10e. The S10e also does not have on glass fingerprint sensor and instead has a capacitive fingerprint sensor on the power button on the side. The S10e has 3100 mAh battery, that is 1000 less than the S10 Plus, but with a smaller screen and lesser cameras, I think it'll be better. And the resolution is also less, so I think that'll be okay. The S10 and the S10e are available in glass back only. The S10 is available in 4 color options: prism white, prism black, prism green, prism blue. While the S10e is available in 5 colors, that is 4 colors of the S10 and 1 additional color, that is canary yellow. I get strong vibes of iPhone XR here. Anyways, when it comes to pricing, the S10e is priced lowest at 55,900 rupees for the 8GB RAM and 128GB storage version, which is the only memory configuration for the S10e. While the S10 is available in 8GB RAM and 128GB storage for 66,900 rupees, that is almost 11,000 more. And at 8GB RAM for 512GB storage at 84,900 rupees. So, that's my review of the new Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus along with the S10 and S10e. If you want to check it out, I will leave links in the description for all three devices. So what I'd like to say is that if you dislike the video, you know where the button is. But if you liked it, do hit a thumbs up and check out more videos here, here and in the descriptions. Do subscribe and share if you haven't already, and don't forget to leave your valuable feedback and suggestions for future videos in the comment sections, and turn on notifications by hitting the bell icon so that you don't miss this great content. Until next time, peace.